bass player for 11th Dimension, and this is my pedalboard, which I use both live and on the studio. The signals chain is pretty straightforward. I come from my bass via wireless unit into an MXR bass compressor, which I chose because it was on Talk Bass Forums the one reviewed as being a good compressor in its price range. Then I go into the source audio programmable EQ, which I use both to tailor my tone and to make all my basses sound the same. Although mainly I only use the 6 strings one right now. Then my signal goes into the distortion box, which is a source audio multi-wave bass distortion Pro. I chose the Pro unit because it has 6 presets and MIDI control, so I can have all my different distortions in one box and switch among them by MIDI. The box is very versatile. It can go from almost a classical bass distortion overdrive to like the synthy stuff and the more electronic stuff used on dubstep and more aggressive distortions for metal. Next in line, I go into the source audio bass envelope filter. I use this box both as a regular wah controlled with a MIDI pedal, but also controlled with a Hot Hand 3 ring, which I have the receptor unit here. I use the distortion going into the filter so that the filter depth sounds wider compared to using a clean sound going into the filter. The bass envelope filter also has 6 presets and it's also MIDI controllable. Then my sound goes into this multi-effects unit. It's a Line 6 M9. I bought it because I talked with Nathan Navarro on Facebook, and he told me that these units are very good for delays and reverbs and octave stuff like that. So that's what I use it for. It is also MIDI controllable. Then my signal goes into a DI that is under here. It splits the sound to my amp and to front of house. I usually send the front of house signal direct from the pedalboard. Finally, I have the big MIDI controller unit, which I use to control the two Source Audio Pro units and the Line 6 one.